What is the importance of a brand ambassador according to you today?
Well, I think product fit is very important, number one. Brand positioning and how the celebrity is projected in the eyes of his target audience. I think these are very important factors.
Okay. Is it also important for the celebrity to be involved in the way they are being marketed or being shown as the face of the brand?
Well, I think absolutely, because unfortunately, I mean, some of us in the business, we've picked up brands left, right and center, and with no disrespect meant, but maybe we believe that those are the right brands. But we picked up certain brands that may not fit us rightly. So it's important to really do research about what you really want to choose.
Okay, so are you also involved in the creatives of VDOT so far? And what are the kind of inputs that you've been giving in?
I've given them my feedback. We spoke about designs of clothes, etc. What would really complement me? Because it's important that they understand what would complement me as much as what I would complement. Because these clothes are actually going out there in the market. It's not something I wear only for a campaign and you don't see it out in the market.
Okay, we certainly see you wearing VDOT. We see you, endorsing Castrol because of their association with FIFA. But at the same time, do we see you using kitchen appliances on a day-to-day basis?
Well, consumer durables was actually high up on the list because I'm a single man. I'm out there. I enter the kitchen myself. I've got a boy who helps me really out there. I am an electronic person. I'm a consumer durable person. I've grown up in that space. And I understand that there's a large space today for a single man or a single woman out there. And it's important to really meet your target audience with that if you choose to do so. And I chose to do so.
Now, if you look at the broader picture in Indian advertising today and relationships between brand ambassadors and brands, if you look abroad, you would see that those associations actually last really, really long time frames as opposed to in India. There are very few examples like, say, Shah Rukh Khan for Tag Heuer. Why do you think that happens in our country?
I believe that brands need to have that kind of faith in their ambassador and vice versa. I believe that brands sign on actors understanding that there is some amount of longevity to the actor. It's also the way we choose our films, which is very important because brands become a derivative of that also. Irrespective, I mean, not, you know, I do have a following irrespective of my success or failure in films. And that's a loyal audience. When I do a good film, I increase our audience base. When I don't, it stays there. So a brand sees that and sees that there's a faithful base. You know, you have a fixed audience and you don't have a floating audience.
Okay, how important is the money aspect in an endorsement deal?
Well, it's important to a point. There's a threshold. There is a point to which money should be paid to a celebrity. But it's important that contractually, whatever you agree on, maybe it's 8 days a year, 10 days a year, you have to give in that much more to the brand because they're putting that kind of faith in you. And I think that's important. If you don't, if you're not part of the process, like your first question was, then I believe that you're just doing it for the money. And I personally don't endorse brands just for the money.
Now, like in the case of VDOT, they've picked a brand ambassador for the very first time. One, is that additional pressure? Two, is it different from taking on a brand from another face that may have been endorsing it?
You're right. There's a lot of pressure because when you're the first, you have to prove yourself. The brand needs to prove itself. You could look great in a campaign, but if your products aren't good, or conversion to sales don't happen, you're not really worth it, or the money paid to you is not really justified.
What we see a lot of brand ambassadors doing is taking their endorsements to their films.
Right.
Do you think that as a concept works, or is the audience smart enough to recognize that it's a plug?
Well, it depends on how you really portray it. Let me give you the best example. Internationally, Brad Pitt endorsed Tissot, the watches. And there's just a moment where you saw his watch before he blew the thing at the start of the film. And that was, it was in there and out there, you know, just out of there in Mr. and Mrs. Smith. If your brand placements in your films are subtle and not in your face, then you're safe, you're fine. But if you're right there in your face, your audience is very intelligent today. Like I did a film where they made one of the actors hold a paint this and they actually played the jingle of the ad. And when you do it so ridiculously, then you're asking for trouble. And it actually got a lot of flack and you don't do that.
I've got a couple of rapid fire ones. One product category that you are dying to endorse and haven't got a chance yet.
Underwear. None of the Indian brands.
You want to endorse it?
Yeah, why not?
Ah, okay.
None of the Indian brands. So I hope VDOT comes out with an underwear.
Okay, interesting. One product category that you are never going to endorse?
Definitely pan masala. Definitely alcohol. Never going to endorse.
Now, we wanted to tie your acting skills to your endorsement deals. And the next couple of situations that I give you, I just need you to express through your expressions. Okay, so you're wearing V-Dot, you're walking into a bar, and a woman is checking you out. All right, okay. The Indian soccer team has finally made it to FIFA. Okay.
You know, I'm really shocked once.
The dusky and the very beautiful Bipasha is very upset with you. You're endorsing a men's fairness cream. All right, final question now. Yeah. This one on a filmy note. You're doing three very interesting films. There's Dostana 2, there's the Hindi remake of Khaka Khaka. What I wanted to ask you about was Saath Khoon Maaf.
Yeah.
And the experience of working with Vishal Bhardwaj.
Well, I think Saath Khoon Maaf is, I mean, working with Vishal's a great process. He's a great director and he really opens you up completely and you do crazy things that you've never done before. Mm. And you'd see that with my role in Saath Khoon Maaf.
All right, thank you so
thank
much.
You.
So you will very soon see John Abraham play Jimmy in Saath Khoon Maaf. With that, time for us to take a breather, but come right back. Next, we are talking about television and how the FIFA World Cup matters to our television screens. Also on the other side, quick ways to help you escape boredom.